What up, what up, what up? Welcome on in, y'all. Let's get it.
Earl Dubs. Volunteer Deputy Mayor. Volunteer Deputy Sheriff. Future Mayor. Coal Miner. Moonshiner. Hog Farmer. Opportunist. Outlaw. Cold.
weird. Yeah, it never takes this long. Something's up.
Dead or alive.
I don't know, but I'm saving that fucking band right there, though, because they just fucking killed it. So you go on the playlist.
Dead or alive.
Yeah, that was tight as shit. I love me some good heavy metal. Hopefully I have me a Geo soon. 7-string Geo. That's what my goal is. Real soon. Should have fucking not wasted my money on that Jack Daniels today. That shit ended up tasting like ass. Anybody want to buy a bottle of Jack Daniels single barrel, holla at your boy. That is killer. That's killer. Love it. Love it. Loving Copperhead. Let's go, baby. If you don't know, now you know.
Well, my name's
John Lee Pillamo.
Same as my daddy and his daddy before. You hardly ever saw granddaddy around here. He only come to town about twice a year. He buy a 100 pound of yeast and some copper line. Everybody around that made moonshine. Now the revenue man want a granddaddy bed. Headed up a hollow with everything he had. For my time, but I've been told and never
he never come back from Copperhead Road. That's a fact. You can fact check it. That revenue went down looking for him, and he never came back from Copperhead Road. The song is actually based on true events, which is why it's freaking amazing. And then he went off to NAMM. He came back with a whole new plan.
Now daddy ran the whiskey in a big black Dodge. Bought it at Knoxville, Mason's Lodge.
What are you thinking? Independent. Opportunist.
Johnson County Sheriff painted
that's Earl Dobbs heritage right there.
Just shot a coat of primer, then he looked inside. Well, him and my uncle tore that engine down. I still remember that rumbling sound. Well, the sheriff came round in the middle of the night. Heard a mama crying knew something wasn't right. He's heading down to Knoxville with a weekly load. You can smell the whiskey burning down Copperhead Road.
I'm gonna go down there and check the front desk. Doom, doom, da, doom, doom. No one ever looked for me here. Well, I'm from 85. Blackwater. Of all the shitholes I get drunk and wake up in.
Morning, friend.
Howdy, buddy. Hey, fella, you don't mind if I ride with you, do you? Get out of here. Ah! Shooty do shoot at me. I better head on up here and turn myself in. Can't be walking around like a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. We'll just wait for the court. And then shoot the judge. Postponed.
Waste of my goddamn time.
I kinda like his wagon. It's pretty nice, actually. I don't mind it at all. I could even have Butters or somebody ride in it. Nobody'd even know they's in there. Then they just jump out like surprise, mother. It'll be enough of the ambushing. Next time, remember when Huck the Kid rides through here, show a little respect. Otherwise, I'm gonna let this 12 gauge eat on you. Sorry about that, little pony. I didn't mean to startle you. Wrongdoers afoot. They forget I'm volunteer junior deputy. I put birdshot all in their ass. think he shot one of my wagon wheels. A little bit bumpier than before. Buddy, out of the way. Coming through, Earl Dubs, future mayor. I'm a wagoneer of sorts. Much better than riding a horse.
Holy shit.
Yeah! You gotta make up some ground. horses. Let's see here. That's the Northland Company. The PO. Ooh. Well, Dubs is good at running. Running. What? Short male, gray outfit with a gray gas mask. Don't know who that is. We'll never find him. Bucket man. I'll still out. Better bill $285 for Earl Dubs. Steak pie. I don't know what that is. Or that. I'm gonna have to go check out Opal over the road there. McCarthy's Farm, good fight night. And that was awesome. Yep, let's go turn ourselves in and collect our bounty. Alright, I guess we're gonna go do it. Now or never. Hey, is there any lawmen around? Hey, there ain't no law around, is it?
No, Earl, you're good. You're okay. It's okay. There's no law right now.
All right, what are you planning on doing?
Well, I was going to turn myself in, but I got scared.
What?
Definitely not going to do any wrongdoing.
Wait, I'm so confused. So who are you gonna go kidnap this time?
Oh.
Never know one.
No, that was just a ruse.
We're gonna put someone 6 feet in the ground. That's what we're going about to go do.
Who?
I don't. You know what? I don't know if I can trust you anymore, Oliver. I don't know if you with us anymore.
Oliver's 8'8". Aren't you?
Are you?
Yes, but who are you gonna go put in the ground?
Maybe he can help us.
It's a certain corrupt lawman.
Okay, well, just tell me, because this determines whether or not I'm gonna watch.
All right, well then, let's go to the hideout then, instead of right here in the middle of the street.
I'm waiting for little Hugo.
So who is it?
Oh, let's go in the office. We're talking in the office. Come on,
right here.
Follow us.
Oh my god.
You're gonna love it. It gets juicy.
I'm really confused. So you say there's a corrupt lawman. Well, who's the corrupt?
Don't worry, I'm always confused, Mr. Oliver. I just follow along. I guess we'll jump the fence here.
Hello. What the?
That little fella scampered right up the wall. Hey, buddy.
Okay, what is going on? Who is the target?
So we're going after a corrupt lawman. We were going for full pardons. Things didn't go as planned. We needed hard evidence. Sheriff Dunn, he's corrupt. I was talking to him. He said some shit, insulted me, told me to nut up or shut up because I threatened him for wasting my time. Basically what he did was he put a hit out on Doc Igby. He wanted me to give me $300 for his scalp.
Yeah. The law put out a hit. Hired us as contractors.
And then they turned around and arrested me and threw the book at me.
And then used that against him, saying you're gonna do it now or we're gonna hang you.
Yep. Now, I went to Marshall's about this. I took the high road. Didn't work out. They said we needed hard evidence. I tried to get hard evidence. We couldn't get hard evidence. I threatened him for wasting my time. I want him to give me $400 for wasting my time. He told me to, I would say, it wasn't very kind. He told me to nut up or shut up, and then to find God. Now we're going to go pay him a little visit.
And now we're going to take him to the train station and drop him off.
Yeah, we're taking him to the train station.
Do you even know where he is?
Well, he's the sheriff of Strawberry.
Yeah, we'll go rob something until he shows up.
Oh, he's the sheriff of Strawberry. We can just go there and check.
Oh, we just roll into town and take him then.
Yeah,
that's we're the Hateful Eight. We roll in and take what we want.
And basically, we're also considering other options. I don't want to, but we might be brought to it. We might have to declare war.
Declare war?
We don't like corruption.
Yeah, corruption's bad. Especially, hold on. It might be good when I'm mayor, but right now it's bad.
This bastard has stabbed me in the back too many times.
Yeah, corruption against us is bad. So you gotta pay. That's the 848 way.
So you're saying that Dunn has stabbed you in the back?
Yeah.
Basically hired him for a hit and then arrested him. Said you're gonna do the hit now or you're gonna hang.
His words exactly. But we don't have hard evidence except for the ears of us as witnesses.
Yeah, he's slicker than butter.
Nazi was a witness. Sheriff Sable was a witness. And Deputy Clyde Barlow.
Oh, we do have Sheriff Sable as a witness. I was going to say us fugitives ain't much for witnesses, but that could be a key witness right there.
But that makes the two of them just as corrupt as Dunn.
Well, true that. Maybe we can use one of them to set up Dunn.
Because they were there when he gave me the hit.
Let's use Sable to set up Dunn.
I think she's corrupt too.
That's why I think we can use her. Corruption always shows its ugly face. That's a fact.
Are you with this? Are you going to sit this one out?
Tell me where you need them and I can sort that out for you.
Oh, yeah, like in a professional manner, like, hey, we're gonna have a business meeting. Mr. Oliver's all official and whatnot. That'd be perfect.
Oh, shit, you're right.
He can lure him to the trap way better than we can.
Little man, what do you think?
I know he's a smart fella.
Did you get shorter?
I think it's his boots.
Everybody keep going.
What the fuck are you wearing?
I'm gonna call my daddy.
What the fuck are you wearing? You're like some sort of demented gold-coated leprechaun from hell. What is that?
There was my,
He's a gnome!
That's your Halloween costume.
Yeah, but I never showed up.
And what are you?
I was like, I don't even know what a member anymore. I was like,
really?
Came from another planet. I had a bunch of stories.
You look so out of place. Somebody would be able to recognize you from a fucking mile away. Change your outfit.
Yeah, I will. I just came back.
If you're going out to kill someone,
go roll around in the mud a little bit or something. You look shiny. Like when butter gets all slicked up.
Okay, where is the rendezvous? What is the trap place that you want to be at?
Well, that can kindly be at your discretion if you're setting it, I reckon. And then we'll just kidnap them and take them from there.
No, rolling into strawberries too, that's not going to work.
Marshall's going to be there too.
Well, is there like a ranch that you can lure him out to check on a horse or something?
There's a house. There's a house near the strawberry stables. There's a little door in.
We'd be waiting inside.
What?
We could be waiting inside and you'd be like, yeah, walk in here and let me show you this house for sale, sorry.
No,
right, ride us out.
This pipe is choking me out. Let me put this pipe out for a second.
Okay, so you know the strawberry, you know the ranch.
the ranch. The stables?
Yeah, the stables.
Yeah.
There's a house there that Murphy used to own. It's still functional.
Yeah, we'll be there.
You guys get to the house, all right? I have Earl's PO, so I can send him a pigeon along the way. I'm gonna write them and figure out where they are.
All right, we'll be.
That sounds like a good plan, I reckon.
All right.
And then from there, we can take them for a little steam. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Where did that little buddy go that was all shiny? That's rad, buddy.
If it'll let me ride. There we go.
I got ambushed by some banditos in the way in here, but that 12 gauge put them in the dirt.
Alright, we'll be waiting, Oliver. Don't cross us.
We'll know real quick if he's hateful, Adrian, not. If not, we'll get the other seven. But I'm pretty sure Mr. Oliver's solid as a rock. He ain't never done me wrong.
So should we just shoot him?
And I think he's the perfect... He's like him, almost like a businessman. He can do all the fancy stuff up front.
You know, I really like that train station idea. We should definitely do that.
Yeah, we just take him from here... Put him on a boat, get as far away from everybody, and then you do the talking, whatever needs to be said, and then we'll say la vie.
He ain't gonna talk.
He don't talk. Just hand, hog time, shoot him in the back room. I'm fine with that.
If we put him on the cliff, he might talk.
Oh. That's a great idea. Man, if we had us one of them in flying baskets, we could just take him up in that and hang him off the side of it. All I know is I got your back, buddy. Two double barrels pointed at whatever.
Who's that?
Might need to send John a telegram if we need some hands.
Yeah, that person.
He might be in county. Ooh. Double back. I'll fire in the air.
I have no idea who it was.
Maybe he heard.
Right, we need to go find Murphy's old house.
Oh, yeah. That's right. We're on a mission. Follow. Oh, he's coming back. Oh, there he is. He's right behind us. Hey, howdy, partner. We thought that was you. That's rad. Good thing about always being dirty is you blend right in. Little buddy fell, he might have fell off his horse. He has trouble riding him sometimes. I think he butters up his saddle too much. You're supposed to do that before we fight, not while you're riding your horse.
That's what I'm saying. You're not supposed to butter up your saddle. You leave the crotch area unbuttered.
That's why you keep slipping off, little buddy.
And you don't put it on your feet either, because they trip around.
I think he went full body, head to toe.
Alright, we need to find this house. Look at your map, see if there's a house near the stables.
Right, Mr. Oliver wrote both of them. He's waiting a response. He's scoping out Strawberry for the high towers.
But where did he go? I think the house is over.
I'll check a map. Yeah, there's a little ranch right up ahead on the left.
I think this is it. Oh, shit.
Oh, check the other one over there. Maybe that's it. We got a horse riding in. It might be little buddy. Yes, little buddy. Over here, little buddy. Over here.
It's locked.
This might be a setup. You don't think he's setting us up, do you? He ain't never done me wrong, but now I'm starting to get eerie feelings here in the fog and locked doors. You might have to make sure you're loaded, just in case.
And I think it's the house up there, when you come into Strawberry. Do you know the Texamite house? The old
one? He said here, at the, he said here, it's Murphy's house. Murphy never owned a taxidermy place.
Well, if there's a
horse mate, trainer here, though.
Let's go check it out, because this is more like the horse trainer, right? Hey, the other day I was down in this place called Dealer, and I shut the sheriff's office, and the door came open. So I went in and pooped right on the desk.
What was the plan? I didn't hear it. I went to
Well, the plan is...
Message Oliver Thomas locked.
Yeah, he was going to lure him here. We were going to be hiding in the house and shoot him in the face.
Tell him this is locked.
Yeah, let me send it out. Hey, do we want to go check out the other place while we wait, just in case?
I'm telling you, this is it.
I mean, I think so too, but, I mean, if there's one close by, it wouldn't hurt to check it. What about the, is it the one on the other side of the stable there? Gotta be this one. I think we're set up.
We go hide in those bushes.
Yeah, let's hide. Let's hide. Perfect. Hey, and if we get separated, just whistle.
Come here, come here, come here, come here. Oh no, we can't see. Coming. We don't want to be too close in case we're getting set up.
Always know your exit arrow. Yep. 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 And you're gone.
Where, Arrow?
Hey, I'm down here. Down here on the rock. Behind. Right here. Hey, where you at? Hey, I'm right here.
Like back here in the dark.
All right, well, I was actually hiding back there on that rock just in case things went south, we can dip down. Hey, come check it out.
I have to see them coming, you know.
Yeah, we can hide right here. If things go south, jump right down. Almost in the shadow, like. See if you can see me right here. Hey, can you guys see me? Hey, psst, can you see me?
A little bit. Just hide, find some cover.
All right, I'm moving to the hillside in the darkness.
No, come here, come here. Just sit here, sit here, sit right here.
What about now? Can you see me, little buddy? Did we send somebody a letter?
Oliver's taking care of it. You tell Oliver that the door is locked?
I did. And hey, fellas, do you see exactly where I'm at?
Someone's coming. Someone's coming. I think. I don't know.
If things go south,
it's not just done. If all of them show up. You have any dynamite?
We should have took a hostage.
I had to ask my dad.
If that's the case, if it's more of them, I'll just come out in the open and then talk some shit. Then we can start shooting if y'all are able to take them out real easy.
I'm number one hitter.
I definitely let this old 12 gauge eat.
Yeah.
Hey, babe.
Hour.
Okay, baby
see
bear.
The hot
ooh, that's a good idea, actually, though.
No, we'll put Vicks on my back. I want my kitchen clean. Where's that?
I hope we get to feeling better. Hope you get to feeling better. Maybe I could make it real hot as you can stand too.
I'm scared of it. It's not like pneumonia. Love you.
Love you, Babbitt.
I hear a lot of horses. Hold on.
A lot of horses. Hey, Butter, you see that valley right there in between them two little mounds right there? Things go south, that's straight down the mountain.
Yeah. I'm gonna switch to the side of the house, see if I can't get away.
Ooh, I just got mail. We gotta go. We gotta go. We gotta move out.
Where to?
To the stables. To the stables. Done and disable. Butter, to the stables. Done and sable. To the stables. Done and sable. To the stables.
In the stable?
Yep. He said come to the stables. They're both at the stables right now.
He said right now?
Yeah, he said, give me the strawberries, they're at the stables.
I don't fucking see them.
I don't trust this. I don't trust this.
You set up?
I don't know. I don't trust this. Go. Tell him a message.
Maybe try sending him a telegram.
You have his P.O., damn it. Oh, yeah, Dunn can't know we're gonna crawl to him.
I heard horses.
Yep. I think that was them. That's a good question. They're trying to surround us.
Circle over to that barn over there.
Bye. you thinking, little buddy?
Oliver is dead already.
That's what I'm thinking.
Hey, they're gonna come. He's gonna alert the police and they're gonna come. Be get in better positions. He's here to help us. There's a thing is, there's gonna be, there's three of them.
But do we have more men?
There's gonna be three, yeah.
So we need to just circle them then, huh, and then take them all.
Yeah, if we can kidnap Dunn, that'd be amazing.
And we hogtied the other two and kidnap him.
Sable's here too, so you could take her as well.
Yeah, yeah. We want to send them to the train station.
We'll take care of Sable.
Or go throw them off a cliff.
Oh. After Butter shoots him in the face. Okay. It sounds a lot more violent than it actually is.
Yeah, it sounds really violent.
Well, that's what we do with corrupt people.
Are you sure this door's locked?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're the master picker, right?
Oh, shit, they're coming. They're coming, they're coming, they're coming. Oliver, they're coming.
I just tell them to take their hands up.
If you can draw them in close.
Should they go out and say something?
Could. Seeing in front of the doors, I can get them in close.
Alright, I'll keep the gun pointed, you just talking.
Of guns.
What do you think? Just draw on them, buddy.
Two in front, two in the back. Tell them we have a marshal. Marksman.
Yeah, we got a marshal at the cave hostage.
This is what I want to show you guys over here. It's really nice house over here. Nice, wouldn't you like to own a beautiful house like this?
Let's go dig.
Hello?
What are you doing?
Alright, hands up, everybody! Hands up! Nobody make a move, nobody get hurt!
I didn't aim at
you. Nobody make a move.
You got your gun out.
His partner over there is aiming at my wife, so I don't feel a need that I have. Can
I just flee my horse?
No need for anybody to get hurt here. Just put the guns down calmly.
I'm getting orders over here for you to put the guns down.
That's good for him. He can order all he wants.
Yep. I got my gun up too.
I never got my gun up. Why are you aiming at me?
What now?
The undersheriff has got guns on her right now.
Oh, so it looks like she's about to get shot.
Yeah, so are you?
Shot, you guys get shot.
No need for anybody to get shot now. We just having a friendly conversation.
We can all talk together.
Talk to him here.
I'm here for Dunn, and I'm here for Sable. Simple as that.
All right. Well, you can talk to him here.
No.
Why do you think I'd give up two deputies? They're two sheriffs. Come on now.
Then I might have to shoot you, but I like you.
I understand that. I like you too some days. And
yeah,
you,
one in the bushes. Watch him. Watch him.
I'm not giving up on my share. Do you know that?
It's not giving up. We're paying him back.
What's
yeah,
all this about?
Unarmed.
Paying back for what?
If you want to talk to him, you can talk to him right here.
Well.
Yeah, why don't you go and talk to us?
Shit, screw it.
I never thought we was gonna talk to him.
Judd's down.
God damn it, Jade, I'm so sorry.
I managed to shoot the little one down before he could get anyone else. Showed up.
Which one is the zoom in and out? I forgot. Shit. I forgot the zoom button.
Oh, my bad. Oh, my God.
All right. My shit's not working. I gotta pop my head. Be right back.
Okay.
Oh, goddamn. Oh. Pain.
Who are missing?
The pain.
I've got Hunter
who do you
on
got?
My shoulder.
Oh, God.
You have Hunter on your shoulder. Okay.
I have the leprechaun on my horse.
Okay. Oh. You got all three. Was there a fourth? No. Just
no.
Three?
Well, they intended for me to be the fourth, but that's not how this shit works.
Well, we appreciate you, Oliver. We really do. You okay, Jed?
Yeah, I think I need to just take a rest.
Oh, Papa's tiny.
Yeah.
Thanks,
a tiny papa.
All right, Jay, let's
thanks,
get
doctor.
Out of here.
Wait, y'all leave?
Yeah,
we're out of the scene. We're dead.
We're dead.
Oh.
horses.
Probably dead.
There it is.
Okay. Is the doctor gonna help with,
Oh, hey, babe. I suppose we can...
Yeah, I was looking up my keybinds to see if I could find them, but...
So if you want to put that one down, I'll handcuff
Yeah, we just had a shootout with the sheriffs. It didn't go so well. We got double-crossed.
This one is the orchestrator, by the way.
The legend grows. Got gunned down by like 6 sheriffs. It didn't go so well.
All right, doctor, if you want
to... Double cross battle law, so there's nobody to run to. Yeah, it's just me and my sawed-off shotgun. Outlaw calling, never mind. I know I seen it on here somewhere. Where is the keybinds at? There they are.
I suppose we'll just wait for Dunn and then Dunn can put him on his.
Loves course. You, babes. Yeah, you'll see me in jail here in a minute.
Oh, you know what? I could lasso him there.
Oh, Dunn is returned.
And the corrupt of law force stays corrupt. But some don't know, some do.
You ugly some bitch.
The story grows, I love it.
Let him put him on the horse. We're gonna take him to the cell first. I have him handcuffed. Done.
All right.
Doctor, if you don't mind just following us to the sheriff's station.
Bottom.
Wrong way.
God damn it, I went the wrong way. I'm sorry. My direction.
Let me get all three. It was a massacre. Oh shit. I hope we're all three in jail together. That shit'll be funny as hell. That'll be some funny ass RP, I hope so. T-Vines, what? What is T-Vines? I don't know what T-Vines are.
Uh-oh. All right, you know what? I'm gonna take the guns off this man first.
It took my guns. Which I already knew anything committed used in the course of a crime.
Oh, where would you like me to put him? Yes, I can just put him.
Did you?
Did I accidentally hockey win?
Anybody's wondering why I haven't checked my mail? It's because I'm dead. Won't be able to check that until I get out of jail and down to the post office.
Make sure he's rid of all the guns he has.
Yep, there he is.
Hold on 1 second, Earl. We'll get you fixed up.
What happened?
No.
It's all right, Earl. Just hold on 1 second.
Sorry.
Well, I hope that worked on you, Go. Oh, yeah, I think you did. Alright. Got a good doctor down here now.
Oh, shit. Butter ain't much on talking. He more for shooting.
Hello, Doctor.
Earl got and Earl had that yeah. See, this is how Earl's day always goes. Earl was riding into town to turn himself in. Next thing you know, get in a shootout with the marshals. Fuck. That's the story of Earl. Some say bad luck would just find him.
All right, Doc.
Ba-da-bum, ba-da-bum, ba-da-doo-doo, doo-doo, da-da-loop, doo-doo, ba-da-bum. Man, I still hope we get some jail and some court RP. the stage is set. Earl's an outlaw.
Doctor?
How'd they get in here?
Well, seems like you were trying to shoot at us.
Oh, how what? You got in here. Me, I was headed to town to turn myself in. What the? Oh, no, I gotta quit drinking.
Earl, you definitely shot at me. I had to shoot you down.
I gotta quit drinking. I gotta lay down. I ain't feeling well.
All right, Earl. Say, boy, I'm gonna handle this.
Sounds good. Sounds good.
I ain't feeling so well. Well, who's that over there? Don't Look like he's gonna make it.
I don't know why. You just got seen by a doctor. You're feeling completely fine.
My head's just a little woozy. I'll try to stand up for you. I'll stand up here as long as I can, and I gotta lay back down.
Alright. Well, you
stop aiming those guns
now,
at me. You couldn't shoot the brow side of a barn.
Yeah, that's
I shot
you
down. I don't
want to
hear your shit.
Guy.
Oh, sorry. I didn't hear you.
You just calm down now. Let the doctor do her work.
Yeah, I was just...
I'll shoot you.
I was going to see a man
down.
About a horse. I don't know what happened.
You need help here, or good?
Nah, he's fine. He's handcuffed.
Make sure my little buddy make sure my little buddy lives.
Fix him.
Fix him. Heal him. Give him some salts.
Doctor, is he in your way? I will get him out of your way if you need it.
I'm just trying to get by. That's all.
You don't need to get by.
Yeah, just get out of the lady's way and go down to the saloon now. Sorry, Marshall. What was what? Sorry.
My friend, I never seen that failure in my life.
Yeah, that's the same reason y'all shooting together. That's right.
Oh, I was there to meet the realtor. Reckon there was a my what?
Your magic number. Oh,
well, I reckon they call me Mayor Earl Dobbs, 97.
97. All right.
Not in no way.
Vote Earl at the next election. Yeah, I was just meeting that fella at the... There was a open house or something there at a property for sale. I'm in the market. You reckon a fella could chew through these bars if he had good teeth?
Oh, thanks, Doc.
I don't think he's gonna make it.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
But I won't take him up to Tumbleweed. I hear they got a good doctor up there.
I'm sorry, Doc. Go ahead.
Yeah, you go wait in the saloon. We'll let you know if he's all right.
At least now you're out of the fucking way.
Hey, can I go to the saloon?
Oliver.
Yes.
Innocent. Amnesia.
Later.
Yes, sir. 97.
Can I get out of jail?
What do you have to show me?
It's this fun little place.
Oh, where'd the doctor go?
Is it the place?
Are you sure it's 97?
And throw them off the cliff.
Yes, sir. Positive. 97.
I'm gonna show you that later.
Talking about my telegram number, right? Where everybody writes to me.
No other reason why
nope,
you be here.
Nope.
You
go
be
ahead
in
and put your eye muscle and whatever is in that bottom right hand corner.
No, I don't think I should be.
Oh, I apologize. 1-3.
All right.
Do you see the doctor? Did you see where she went?
Yeah, she just went upstairs.
Okay.
I ain't used to having to carry one of them IDs around town, you know what I mean?
Why do you think I should be in one of the cells with
you? I ain't never been in a town that fancy. A bug tussle ain't nothing like this.
I'm done talking to you, Oliver. You gonna get what's coming to you. You ain't in a cell with us. You said you was with us.
Hold on. What? Why is he standing out there? He's the mastermind.
Seems to have a trend with rumors around here.
What'd you say, Earl?
He's the mastermind. Why ain't he in here? Do we look like we're smart enough to pull something like that off? I mean, look at me. Come on.
He told us where to go and who was going to be there.
Look at him. Look at us. Who do you think pulled that off?
You can see how much he paid me to be here.
I think you should let me go and I'll go investigate. I mean, I'm volunteer deputy.
Give me a gold bar.
And I know who the guilty party is. That man right there.
Mr. No Mercy, can you just go towards the end of the cell, please?
Be difficult.
I'm glad you're back up on your feet, little buddy. Just go wait at the saloon, and they'll fill out your paperwork for you.
All
right. Let me out of my hog.
Don't make me do it.
Trial?
I am requesting a trial. I'm an innocent man by amnesia.
All right.
Hold on, what's the charges? What's the trial for?
Well, looks like you got two first degree murder, plus your bounty that you have out for you.
Oh no, who did I kill?
Get me out of these cops.
You killed that marshal and you killed him, my deputy.
God damn it.
Oh, well, it was by accident. If I did, I promise, I heard shooting and got scared and the gun's like, boom, 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 I was just running. If you actually seen, I was running.
It's locked, damn it.
All right, well.
All right, get back in there.
You have a chance to prove that.
Get in there.
Hey, you trial, but you also be
I will let you out of your cuffs.
You
get in the cell.
I'm in the cell.
I'm doing.
Well, I'll have to get a hold of Dobbs and Pettimore.
All right, well. Yeah, I'm gonna assume you're gonna represent yourself, so.
Well, either me or Mr. Don will represent one of us.
Hey, let me
Don,
out of these cuffs.
Did you search Hunter here?
Got no guns on me.
The blue jacket.
Oh no! What happened? 20. I thought I got to wait on trial. Well, I'm already in jail. When I go to trial, I'm gonna move that this gets towed out. Time served. I guess I can get my exercise in. Ain't that what they do? Doom, 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 doom. I wish you had them. Huh. You could definitely make a super cool place here. Do, 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 do. Hey, did they take my guitar? Huh. That's on them, buddy. I can sit here and keep myself entertained for days. Oh, they took it from them. That'd be son of a... I'll just play my imaginary guitar like I used to back at Bug Tussle. Sitting behind these old walls, doing nothing but time. Not guilty's what I said to the judge. He said, "You're guilty to me." Here, I sit behind these concrete walls. I don't know where I go from here, but an outlaw will always ride again. I wonder if it took my trumpet. Let me go over here and see if he got one in this box over here. I think it's for when I get out here. Perfect. Can somebody dynamite me?
I kind of wish they would let the jail scene play out longer. I feel like I got shipped off to prison pretty quick there after it was like bloop bloop. Jail RP seems like it would be fun. More fun. At least they could have put my buddies in here with me. We could all been in here together. You know something? I'm still not understanding how I went to prison. If I was requesting a trial, I ain't even been found guilty yet. Oh no. Oh no. Road ashore, hallelujah. Ooh. You're wondering how I sang and played the trumpet? I sang through my nose. Is there anybody from county that's can answer an out of county question? I don't think I've seen it in the rule book anywhere, and I definitely read over it before I would ask. Now, what's the rule here? Do I wait as Earl, or can I go into my other character and just Earl's done for the night? Can I shut Earl down for the night and come back as Ryan? Since he's technically in prison. Like, I got another character, Ryan Cheatham. So, like, since Earl's technically in prison, I mean, do I have to wait the 20 minutes first, or can I just like go ahead and log out of Earl and come back as Ryan? But you do. No, I'll wait it. I mean, I'll wait the time this time. I don't wait half the time this time. That's why I was wanting to clarify what it was. So you still got to wait the time, but then from there, switching characters is probably better anyway, so that you're technically in prison longer, right?
Hey, buddy, can you kill me in there, please?
Oh, hey, what happened?
Just kill me in there, bro. I don't even see nothing in there.
I don't even know how we got here. I was standing there talking to the sheriff, and he's like, hey, I'm gonna let you go, because you know about wrongdoers and whatnot. And I was like, yeah, I'll see you in court. And then they got me on the wagon, and I thought they was gonna take me home, and they brought me right here. I feel like I got him set up twice. I don't think Mr. Oliver was with us.
Told you so many times I don't trust him.
I know, I should have went with you good, little buddy. Next time I'll know. I knew as soon as we rolled up and it was foggy and wasn't nobody there, and then I seen the horse go around the hill that we probably should have just left. But I thought we was going to be able to negotiate a little bit, but, Wild Bill Butter, you know him. He's like, fuck it. Now I think I got a whole lot of charges on me. Funny thing is, I was riding into town to turn myself in, then got myself into a whole heap of trouble. Double-crossed by the law, now there's nobody to run to. It's just me and my little buddy Hugo and Butter.
Wait till I get out of here, man. You see what I do with Oliver.
He's the first one going to the train station.
Fucking ass.
Nobody's ever been under my watch, but I think it's time. We take him all the way out to the North Point, the coldest part. We take all his clothes off, hog time, and leave him. He'll freeze to death before he gets back to town. Natural causes. If the wolves and the cougars don't eat him first. I wonder what they done with Butter. They must have put him on the other side of the prison. How long is your sentence, little buddy? Look like they give me 10 to 20. Huh. I gotta beat it in court, otherwise I'm gonna have to find a way to bust out. I can't never do 10 to 20. These is my prime years. Well, don't ask me how I got this trumpet in here, but I'll play us a little tune.
Shuffle the deer.
Just swap the end off, it'll be fine. That's what I love about RPing too, because I love to make people laugh. If I can say something and make somebody or a whole group break and crack, that's just hilarious. Oh, I knew you was gonna end up in here eventually. Doom, doom, oh. Doom. Yep, yep.
Hey, do you have eyes watching you?
Yeah.
Can you,
Yeah, I know what to do. Hang on 1 second.
All right, cool.
I've been talking like crazy. I ain't got my mic on or nothing. Fuck. Well, Earl's out of prison now. We made a great escape that nobody's seen. It was legendary. Fuck. Alright, I give up. I can't find a gun store. Can't find one. I don't even think one exists right here. I think it was all a lie. I will give it one more try. There's literally supposed to be one right here. Unless it's in this alley. Is it? Might be. I don't know. Fuck. I don't think it is.
Good morning to you.
I give it up. I'm heading down here. This ain't Denny's gun store. Yeah, I'm getting my wagon and heading up out of here. Hey, little buddy.
Hey, moving already.
Where'd Buddy go? I'm sorry, Don. Are you okay? Get out of here, Don. We might have just found us a ride.
Jesus! Somebody help me!
No.
Me and the DM, bro.
Do they charge me any money or just time in jail? Oh, they did take my guns. I don't even know how much money they had on me, honestly. I ain't gonna check it yet. I better wait till I get to town. Jump off his horse, he might leave me. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I don't know what happened there. Definitely something in the road or something there, maybe. Oh no, and there's a train coming. Sorry, horses. I'm out of here. Better up for the stab you and put y'all down for that. Better than let the train hit you. Oh no. Y'all gotta get out of the way. Y'all doomed. Army wagon. Usually carrying gold.
Right, since Earl is freshly out of jail and he's not trying to be hemmed up in some shit, he's done for the night. Time to break out Ryan Cheatham. Cheatham County's finest. You just talk normal like me. I ain't gonna try to do nothing crazy. Yeah. Yeah. Ryan Cheatham.
I don't know exactly what happened. Was this after I got shipped off to prison? Then again, I was in my own little scene over there bullshitting the other sheriff. I don't even really know what happened. Like, legit. That's what was taking so long for y'all to come to prison, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's probably definitely some work that needs to be done there. Like you said, if we're doing true dead roleplay, which I don't necessarily like that as much as severely wounded in the doctor, your character's done for the rest of however long. You know what I'm saying? So that way, there's no way if you're severely wounded, dead, whatever you want to call it, that no matter what, your character has to stay gone for this amount of time. Which is why it's also a plus to have a secondary character, I think. So when that happens, you can just go hop on your secondary and still be in county and still be playing and having fun. But, you know, that scenario played out to where that character's in jail, that character's in the hospital, that character's whatever. But that scene's going to go on without them. Like you said, if they come right back in, no matter what. I mean, kind of like me being heavily wounded and then coming back at the jail. I kind of like that to be played out. Like, maybe I wake up tomorrow at the jail and, you know, Earl's done for the night. The sheriffs are there. Talk it out then, get sent up to the prison. I don't know how all that looks or how it works. So I'm just, in my mind, that's just what I'm rambling. Yeah, that's why I had the suggestion for the severely wounded. That way nobody ever dies, because in the role play, if Earl gets shot today and dies, how do I come back anyway? I get heavily wounded and I've been in the hospital for the last week, storyline-wise, and the docs took care of me and I come hobbling back into town injured. I feel like that plays way better. Yeah, I don't even, like, not even pick up and revive. Like, pick up, revive in a sense, but revive, they got to be sent to the hospital, and the hospital's kind of like jail where there's a timer that you can't come back. Ooh, maybe that's it. Like, if you're heavily wounded to the point that your character's dead, then he is. But when you go to the dock, just like jail, there's a time limit, a big time limit on when you can come back, depending on, I don't know. I mean, I guess you could have a level 1, 2, and 3, or like depending on the injury, but that might work. And that way, even say like, just say like a troll got on there one day and we're having RP and they just keep reviving or something, like that would definitely prevent that, because then they would have so long before their character could come back if you get killed. In that scenario. Now, if it's a revive scenario for the doctor or the barber, that's different. You can be revived. But if you're in a gunfight and you're heavily wounded, the sheriffs take you to the dock and your character's out. Same with the sheriffs. They get taken to the dock and their character's out for like whatever that time limit is. I'm just messing around with Ryan here for a minute. If I load in, so yeah. We're gonna have to reload this. Definitely won't be. Can we turn the? It's probably cooler in our bedroom though when we snuggle. Snuggle buggles, wiggle wiggles. She likes to spank my booty. I twerk it and she works it and spanks that booty. She says, twerk it, let me work it. I put the game down, flip it, and reverse it. It's your reminiccum-yay-ho. Let me give y'all some advice. Don't ever buy a Jack Daniel's single barrel. It tastes like burnt hair. If you had ass hair that was burnt and then you put it in charred wood and then you poured ethanol or nail polish in it and then stirred it all together. That was some rough shit. But the beauty of the bourbon that don't taste good is beautiful wifey there, aka Silver Cherries, can take them and turn them into amazing whiskey glazed gourmet nuts. She took a bottle of bourbon last year that I thought tasted like shit and made some of the most amazing nuts you ever put in your mouth. When you put wifey's nuts in your mouth, you want some more of them. Man, I love that. That's awesome. Oh, it'd be so cool too if they ever do like where it switches scenes every now and then. Like maybe like for whatever reason, there's a banjo version of Copperhead Road. That's not copyrighted all to hell. Oh man. Alright, Earl's in prison, escape prison, on the run, he don't know. Say hello to his little buddy, Ryan. He's Earl's cousin, twice removed by marriage. He speaks a lot better than Earl, he thinks a lot better than Earl, and he shoots a lot better than Earl. He might not be as funny, but comedy ain't what he's here for. He's here for taking all the money, and running all the businesses, 10% security. Pay straight to the Cheatham Foundation. And folks will be like, we don't need security. After we rob them a few times, they're gonna need security. Thanks, buddy. Ooh, I gotta put it on 52, don't I? Let me drop that down. They say it's 50. See my homies laid out with our tops blowed off. That's 50. And that wasn't 50. Don't holler my name. We gotta get us an outlaw ranch together. Web Ryan and Earl and Hugo and Butter and John. About all the people I met so far I could trust to bring in to the heathens. I'm about to, little buddy. I'm about to walk in here and take what's mine. Ryan Cheatham style. Ain't got no money? Buenas tardes. You just walk in here and take it. Where's the local grocery at, ma'am? Seed and feed.
This is bad.
Give me all your money. Put all the money on the bar right now.
I'm just gonna get out of your hair, all right? Devil on a stick. The devil!
Riding through town last week, dragging some helpless farmer by goddamn rope.
What's this place?
Howdy.
Not enough lawmen, hey? Hey, Dan.
Oh, Ryan's doubly fucked. He don't have no map or compass.
I can't even find me a general store to rob.
Hold on, Ryan, don't talk like that.
You know,
my can't find me a general store nowhere around here to rob. What it used to be. All I need is me one general store, and I have all the money and goods I need. Because I'll take it all. We might have found this one right for the picking.
Other day, I spotted a few hussies walking the street with bare shins. Nearly put me in the grave.
What in the world is happening to this?
Hello? Heads or tails, amigos?
That's not right!
Oh. No trouble!
Loosen your teeth!
Mira.
I ain't through with
you! What are you doing? Maldita sea!
Engendro del demonio!
Tell him Ryan was here.
Howdy, partner. You ever been punched off a horse?
You out of your damn mind?
How'd you like that? Now I want your gun.
I thought this was a civilized country.
I thought I value, huh? No ammo, no nothing. Looks like a run in his pockets. He got a gun on him. name's Ryan. Give me all the money in your pockets, and nobody gets hurt. Wrong answer.
Somebody, anybody, help! Jesus Christ!
Christ in hell.
That ain't right.
No, por qué, sinvergüenza?
No problemo, por favor. No problemo. No worries, my auto mod catches it. You have to misspell it like Puss K. Wait till the lawman meet Ryan. He has no respect for the law, takes what he wants, kills who he wants to, until they hang him. That's his bloodline. Got a gypsy soul and a rebel yell.
No. Get away! Oh, God! Help me, God damn it! need help right now! God damn! No, don't!
Let's ride, Zeus. You got two options here, sir. I can leave you here for the wolves. Hang on, I know. I gotta practice rhyme before I get around other characters. You got two options here. I can leave you out here for the wolves. Or we can see if you can swim. Wolves sound hungry. But I think you can fly. Let's see. Nope. I didn't think he could fly. The feller said he could fly. I didn't believe him. That's right, Zeus. Beautiful out here. Some might say this is Ryan's country. Gotta link up with my cousin Earl.
Ugly business here. Thank you.
morning, sir.
You well, then? Let's go.
Morning.
Christ's sake! You can die!
Strawberry that way. That's the way we be going.
Fuck, I don't have no ammo.
We get the strawberry wall. We'll bunk down at the saloon and I'm going to chill with the wifey. Yo, Greg, yeah, what up? Earl got into a shootout earlier. Got sent to the slammer. How in the fuck do we keep ending up back in Blackwater? Am I in the fucking ozone? This is preposterous. How did I end up back in the town that I just fucking left? If I end up, if the next town I end up in is Blackwater again, then I'm just logging out anyway. Holy shit, I've come back to Blackwater 3 times. Ryan has to get a map and a compass before his wagon falls apart. I'll bury that way. Alright. Howdy. That'd be a real nice outfit. A rat smart outfit out here.
In between Blackwater and Strawberry. Mental note. Big ass outfit.
I was just making a mental soap. Oh yeah. Don't ask me how I smuggled that trumpet in. But I had one in there. And then Butter came in and Hugo came in and they both had lockpicks, so they lockpicked the back door and we escaped out. I might be lost. So Earl had to go lay low for a while, bring Ryan out for a bit, get him acclimated to the county. And what was that place? That's a nice little spread. Some kind of nice little outfits in between. I really liked that last one. Might have to look, ask the realtor about that one.
Like we're in Blackwater.
Ah! yeah. I'm out of here, yo. Fourth time is a motherfucking charm. Ryan is trapped in the fucking Twilight Zone.
Where the hell was I?
I've been thinking about going back to Chicago. They should call this town back.
Go on and move! Hope you...
You gonna draw on me, old man? I was just gonna take yours.
Don't
you ever draw it, big iron on me, unless you intend on using it. You got it? What are you looking at? Huh?
How'd you do?
That's what I thought. I'm doing just fine. Howdy, partner. Ryan, is the store open? I need to go make a withdrawal.
Shit never ends.
Rightio. Time to go kick it with a wifey, catch a movie. I'll catch y'all tomorrow. Break it. No mercy, everybody. Y'all the best. We'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace, love, and Red Dead.